at that time in the 60s. Oh man, these were beautiful human beings who had experienced a whole lot of ugliness. And the whole thing was beauty and kindness toward each other. And I don't want to over-glorify it, but I remember thinking at the time, gee, I wish my relatives were like this, you know? Yeah. Or, yeah, wow.
Different world, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's a different
world. And it's, to make something from absolutely nothing of such great beauty, you know? Yeah. That's what I tell my students, you know? You have to dig deep.
Yeah.
You know, you really do.
You do, yeah. That's as creative is.
Yeah.
Because to make something from nothing, I mean, in our culture, we call that basically God.
Yeah, that's what it's not you.
No.
But it's becoming a conduit.
That's it, it's becoming a conduit. Right.
And I find that more and more, the longer I play music, if I just stay out of the way,
it's
there. I can just plug in,
right.
And I, there's no me.
Right.
There's just.
That's right. Yeah. There's not so much effort necessary, is there?
Right. No.
There's a point. I'm sure there's a point when you're drumming and you probably just drift off somewhere, and just come back to the drums later.
Well, it's kind of like
Must be something like that because.
It's kind of like a spell comes over me and
right.
I'm transported. In fact, it used to be very difficult for me to come out of that at the end of a set.
Mm-hmm.
And somebody wants to talk to me, and I'm still like in the zone. When I came to the UK, I started teaching at the Royal Academy of Music in London and Birmingham Conservatoire. And that's just been great because that's now been going on, you know, for long enough for me to see the students that I taught, you know, begin their professional careers and advance and, you know, put out their own records. That's very satisfying. It makes me feel useful. It's not just me up there playing for my own enjoyment, you know. I get to pass some knowledge, and I learn from them too, obviously. They keep me on my toes.
That's what jazz is, though, isn't it? I mean, if you look at the beginning of jazz, there were basically schools. The new musicians would be brought in by a friend. They'd be introduced to Louis Armstrong. Louis Armstrong would, you know.
Well, one of the things was the big bands. You know, young guy. I'm reading this Dexter Gordon book that just came out.
Oh yeah.
And talking about he's like 17 or something, and Lionel Hampton hires him, you know. And so what would happen is the older guys in the band would actually, that was school. They tell you how to live. They tell you what to eat, what not to eat.
How to dress.
How to dress, how to carry yourself, what to do with your money, how to blend with an ensemble.
Yeah.
You know, help you with your sound, all that. And so that's kind of what I got with Stan in a way, because he wouldn't say much, but for example, he'd say, well, can you do the same thing, you know, keep the intensity but without the volume?
Mm-hmm, right.
You know, things like that, you just say that, you know. And I'd think, no, I can't. I've got to work on that.
Yeah.